Well, I'm using the power of layering by taking some black.
Today I'm going to be showing you how I painted this dough in watercolor. Hi, I'm Sara, and I make art.
Before we start, though, I make videos to help you get better as an artist, so if you don't want to miss any of them, be sure to click the red subscribe button below this video and click the bell to turn on notifications. For painting in watercolor, you want to make sure that the layer you put over another layer has less water than the layer under it. If the layer on top has more water, it can cause the layer under it to lift, even if the layer underneath is dry. You always start with your lightest colors in an area because those are your most watery layers. So that's why I'm starting with these reeds, because they're a light yellow and that's the lightest shade in this area of the painting. I put water on my paper to dilute the paint, and I sprayed water into the paint on the palette, but that wasn't enough. I still had to dab the paper with my tissue to lighten the color. I want the edge of the deer's back to stay white because there's light hitting it. I also want the edges of his ears to stay white. And to save me the stress of worrying about accidentally putting paint on those areas, I am putting masking fluid down on those areas right now. I want the base of the deer's body to be grayish brown. So my first attempt to get that was to mix burnt umber with Payne's gray. And as I'm putting it on, you can see probably that it's not looking very grayish. It just looks like a straight brown. That's okay. You'll see what I'll do about that later. I don't want to accidentally paint over the reeds that I painted, so I switched to a smaller brush and I'm painting very carefully around here. Her legs are much lighter than her torso, so I'm using that old dabbing trick again. Just filling in his ear now with some red that's been watered down, so now it's pink. And for the shadow, I'm just using that same color with just less water in it. There's a hard edge where her head meets her ear, and I'm dabbing that with the tissue. Remember I said I would do something about that color that wasn't quite right? Well, I'm using the power of layering by taking some black, which is actually watered down so it's more like gray, and painting that right over my brown, which is dry, by the way, that's important. And this black, or this gray rather, layered over this brown, gives me more of that brownish gray that I'm looking for. I'm putting masking fluid down now because there are some leaves in this area, and I want to make sure the paper where they're going to be stays white. And it would be really hard for me to just paint around those areas. These masking fluid spots are actually leaves that are being hit with very bright sunlight, so they look white. I'm writing down this area of the paper first so that the paint flows better and doesn't go on too dark. This is emerald green mixed with ultramarine blue that you're seeing me paint here to get a nice blue-green color. I'm wetting down this part of the paper again because I want the edges of the next layer I'm going to put on top to be soft. I knew early on looking at this photo that I was going to put a purple shadow on the deer, so I'm doing that now and I have purple mixed with the black that was already on my palette. We don't use white in watercolor, so when I want something to be grayish, I actually mix black into it and then I water it down and it becomes grayish. I'm definitely going to need to go over these with black and maybe even some purple, but I'm blocking in the darker colors on his face now. And now I'm layering over those spots with watered down black, so it's more like gray. And I'm doing that so that the purple that I'm going to put on top later won't look so bright. That's going to have to dry for a bit. In the meantime, there's some work that needs to be done on the ears. I'm doing this using wet on dry. I have very little water and very little paint in my brush so that I can have the control that I need to make these shapes that I want. I'm also being careful to leave some of that white edge. I'm giving her brown corneas. Brown corneas seems a bit weird to me, but that's what they look like in my reference photo. Softening the edge of this shadow a bit. I'm taking that same blue-green that I used to paint the background the first time, but without wetting the paper this time, and using a small round brush that has very little water and very little paint in it, I'm using that color to paint texture in this area. It's not really that important to follow the reference photo that closely here. I just need to get some variety in. There's one spot in here, by the way, that has a lot of extra pigment in it, so I'm borrowing from it for the others. Still using that same blue-green color, but with the paper now dry so that the value will be darker, I'm painting the bushes above the doe's head now. I want there to be some highlights on these branches on this side. So again, I'm putting down some masking fluid, but I'm putting it down in streaks this time to follow where those highlights are going to be instead of in dots. I hope that makes sense. Before I paint the bushes on that side, I'm going to paint the ground under the doe's hooves so they don't absentmindedly paint over it with green. And to paint that, I've chosen to use a light pinkish brown. And I'm dabbing with a tissue because I'm planning to paint darker twigs and sticks on top of this. After I dabbed it, the color was a little too light for my taste, so I built it up a little with another layer and then dabbed that. Now my masking fluid is dry, and I'm painting my branches now with a small round brush, and I'm using the same color that I used for the deer's body, except I just have more black mixed into it, so it's even more grayish. I really wanted these to be lighter than I'm making them here. I'm hoping to be able to go back and lighten them later. For the bushes here, I'm actually using a yellowish green, almost more of an olivey green. This is why you need to look at your reference photo closely, by the way. I got this color by accident. I had the yellowish green that I was mixing on my brush when I was trying to get black from the one part of the palette to mix into that green, and the colors ended up mixing in part of the palette with the black in it. But when I looked at it, I saw that it was the perfect color. But anyway, I'm painting wet on dry, and I'm painting very carefully, especially when I get close to the edges, around where I have the brown painted, so I don't cover that up by accident. I'm painting some brown in these bushes now, and I'm using a small round brush for this. And I really don't want to lose that highlight that I put masking fluid down specifically to preserve, so I'm making sure to put my edge of brown right above it. You probably see that I'm going right over some of the green and right through some of the white. That's perfectly okay. In fact, I want some of these colors to overlap each other. I want the brown in this bush area to be fairly dense. So I'm looking for where can I add little clusters, where can I add little things going off of other things, just little things like that. There's more white showing on these branches that I want. So you just saw me painting more of that same color on them. And I was trying really hard to make sure I still left some white showing. I was like, don't get to the edge, don't get to the edge, don't get... Sitting down to work on this again, and I see that there's really not this whole strip of white showing. There's actually brown in this part and just little bits of white showing. So that's what I'm taking care of here. And I'm finally giving her some pupils. I'm just doing little touch-ups, a little around the ear, a little around her cheek, little around her shoulder, just to fill it out a bit more. Because leaving this much white showing is a bit bizarre. Now this is something that most watercolor teachers will probably tell you not to do, but it's perfectly fine, it's perfectly archival. I'm taking some white acrylic paint and painting it over areas that I forgot to leave white, but I want to be lighter than the color underneath them. And I'm going to paint some light brown on top of that. I struggled to get this brown right. It came out too gray, and then you'll see one time I tried to dab it with a tissue and I got paper stained. Look, I got fast enough that I was able to lift most of it off. But anyway, I just put some plain burnt umber on a little part of my palette, sprayed some water in that, and just used that for everything, and of course dabbed it with the tissue so it'll be lighter. And I can't forget to paint the rest of the brown. I still had my pinkish brown left from last time. And you see that in part of this, I'm going pretty slowly, and you might see me hesitate a bit. That's because I'm trying to make sure that I don't accidentally paint over my lines that I painted. I've actually recently gotten back into watercolor. I've been working in acrylics for years before that. I've made some videos where I demonstrate one painting in both mediums. And this one where I painted pink rose is the first one of those that I did. I make videos to help you improve as an artist. You can find two more of them over here. If you don't want to miss any, click over here to subscribe so I can help you bring out your creativity. Thanks for watching.